There's that old saying, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. But some Republicans may not be reading it the way it was intended. With their races getting tough and with debates getting rough, they are going away. They are just skipping debates. This happened with Senator Lindsey Graham in South Carolina. It reportedly happened with Senate candidate Roger Marshall in Kansas. And then the latest is Senator David Perdue in Georgia. He's skipping the last Senate debate after, which is against his Democratic challenger, John Ossoff, so that he can attend a Trump rally in Georgia. But I'm sure this moment from his last debate is probably also still on his mind.
Well, perhaps Senator Perdue would have been able to respond properly to the COVID-19 pandemic if you hadn't been fending off multiple federal investigations for insider trading. It's not just that you're a crook, Senator. It's that you're attacking the health of the people that you represent. You did say COVID-19 was no deadlier than the flu. You did say there would be no significant uptick in cases. All the while, you were looking after your own assets and your own portfolio, and you did vote 4 times to end protections for pre-existing conditions.
Essie Cupp is a CNN political commentator. She's also the host of CNN's Essie Cupp Unfiltered. I mean, it's just so weird to see all these candidates skipping out on these chances to make their cases to voters. What do you think about this pattern?
Well, you said the magic word, voters. I mean, to me, it's just another in a long line of middle fingers to voters. When you won't show up to debate your record or explain a proposed record, forgive me, it's an F you to voters. And it comes from the very top. When the president of the United States won't show up to a planned debate, when he storms out of interviews with journalists that he doesn't like, and of course, the big one, when he tries to prevent you from voting, I think it's safe to say the Republican Party of Trump doesn't have any respect for the will of voters.
It's also, I mean, it makes me think of how, look, a lot of people deride this idea of cancel culture. We hear it a lot from Republicans, but this just seems to be part of that to me, that they're just blowing this off and they're kind of canceling their appearances.
Well, they're blowing off the voters. And I think we all stand to be reminded that they are public servants. They work for you and me, Brianna, not the other way around. And so this idea that they don't have to be held accountable to the voters, to the press, to internal and external oversight, to checks and balances, this really is sort of an overriding of long-held, you know, political tradition that they are servants. And again, it starts from the top and it trickles down. And Trump has created a culture of unaccountability. And frankly, I hope it's one of the first things that Joe Biden does, if he's elected, is to restore that idea of accountability to voters, to the press, to oversight, to Congress, because that's been sort of eroded over the past 4 years.
Okay, so I wonder here, just a few days out from the election, how you're feeling, because we're hearing from a lot of people who just think they just don't know what to think after 2016, where everything seemed completely upended from what expectations were. So how's it looking to you?
I have been, I'm sure you have too, just from covering 2016 the way we did, I have been having some serious flashbacks. Hillary Clinton was up 14 points around this time. In 2016, I was talking to lots of smart people who were saying it was kind of hers to lose. Now, we heard from some folks who said, no, Trump voters are underrepresented. I always agreed with that they were underrepresented in the polls, but I didn't think there would be enough of them to really, swing it for him. And at least when it came to the popular vote, we were right. But this time, I'm just as nervous, frankly. Biden's doing just as well as Hillary was. He doesn't have her unfavorables. That's positive for him. But I don't think national and even statewide polling is all that predictive when it comes to presidential races. So I really don't know what to expect on Tuesday or the coming weeks.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are in that boat with USC. Who knows?
And the message is to vote, Brianna, vote. Because even if you think you're in a state where it doesn't matter, it really will this year. Every single vote will matter, especially when the Republicans are trying to suppress them all over the country.
All right, SE Cupp, thank you so much for joining us.